करुणा सागरी मां नित्येश्वरी करुणा सागरी मां
करुणा सागरी मां नित्येश्वरी करुणा सागरी मां
करुणा सागरी मां नित्येश्वरी करुणा सागरी मां
भरणी
मां नित्येश्वरी कारुण्य रूपिणी मां
कांचन भरणी मां नित्येश्वरी कारुण्य रूपिणी मां
कांचन भरणी मां नित्येश्वरी कारुण्य रूपिणी मां
Swamiji is ultimate thing which happened in my life. After doing Kriya Yoga, Mahavatar Babaji's Kriya Yoga, third level, I intensely prayed to Mahavatar Babaji that I wanted a living master. I was deep in search of living master. Then that is how I came across with my friend. He told me, "Why, let's go to Bhardi, there is a young master." Nityadevan Yoga was the first program which I attended directly with Swamiji. He said, "You will experience like bamboo. You will feel that empty inside your body." I started doing intensely that meditation, and immediately I could see that experience is happening inside me. I went to that thoughtless state where I felt like complete empty inside my body. That is the first thing which I experienced with the master. That time I decided, he is my guru. After Swamiji's teachings, what happened is I could see my body or my mind or everything as so mature to the higher level. The ego is not there, that I is not there. Now, whatever it's there, it's always you. I love to worship, I love to do my puja. Happening Paramahamsa in your life is, I mean, you have many janmas you would have prayed for that. And I'm lucky to have that incarnation has happened in my life.
As I said, this city is, if you understand, the most fascinating. Please understand, this city is literally cosmos. If you understand, you will find such a great order in the chaos. If you don't, you will find chaos, so much of chaos in everything. The person who understands, for them, this city is most fascinating. If you don't understand, this will be most frustrating. Just like life. If you understand, most fascinating. If not, most frustrating. Get ready for a spiritual blast.
When you eat garlic, and garlic is there in your stomach, whenever you belch, that smell will only come out. So if only if you're really incomplete and you have that incompletion inside you, only then it will be projected outside.
Adding to his point, Swamiji also said, the egg has to be broken from inside, not from outside. So only when you realize it within, you'll really experience it. And if other people around you also tell, whatever they tell, that's actually irrespective, because you have to realize that from inside.
As we all have experienced in Gurukul, if you same thing, go and tell it to the plants in front of the plants, then the plants will start growing thorns. The rose plants will start growing thorns. But the same thing, even if you don't have any context, and if you still tell the right words, compassionate words to it, still the plant will drop its thorns, right? See, because before I came to Gurukul, before I started the process of speaking to the rose plants, during engineers I had a process where we grew mustard in two cups, and in one cup we had to go shout at it, and in the other cup we have to speak to it with lots of love. So the cup in which the mustard plants grew, where I shouted, just died within maybe 2 days, but the other plants grew very healthily. So I feel that your words directly are affecting the things around you.
Now even you have consciousness, and the plant has consciousness. So when you reflect bad space in your consciousness, even it will sense that bad space, and even its consciousness will become bad. But if you reflect good consciousness, then even it will reflect good consciousness back to you.